Welcome back, guys, and in today's video, we'll be talking about Google Cloud Platform, simply known as GCP. But before that, if you're new here, make sure to subscribe and turn on notifications as well. So cloud computing today allows hardware and software products to coexist remotely in data centers and at scale. Together, these products work to deliver specific services so users typically can access, manage, and use the tools they require through a web interface, and that's true for Google Cloud Platform. So Google Cloud Platform, offered by Google, is a suite of cloud computing services that runs on the same infrastructure that Google uses internally for its end user products, which includes Google Search, Gmail, Google Drive, and YouTube. So in 2008, Google announced the App Engine, a platform for developing and hosting web applications in Google managed data centers, and that was the first cloud computing service from the company. And as of today, Google Cloud Platform offers over 90 services across areas such as networking, infrastructure, machine learning, data analysis, building and managing applications, databases, and many more. The major services on GCP include computing and hosting, networking, storage, database, big data, and machine learning. Now let's talk about the global infrastructure of Google Cloud. So GCP offers services for 24 regions with 73 availability zones in over 200 countries. A region is a specific geographical location where users can deploy cloud resources, and each region consists of availability zones where each zone has redundant and separate power, networking, and connectivity to reduce the likelihood of two zones falling simultaneously. And each availability zone holds one or more data centers, which houses computer systems and associated components used by organizations for the remote storage, processing, or distribution of large amounts of data. So in order to deploy fault-tolerant applications with high availability, you should deploy your application across multiple zones in a region to help protect against unexpected failures. And GCP is a public cloud vendor, so customers are able to access computer resources housed in Google's data centers around the world for free or on a pay-per-use basis. With Google Cloud's pay-as-you-go pricing structure, you only pay for the services you use. No upfront fees needed, no termination charges, pricing varies by product and usage only. Google uses GCP internally for its end-user products such as Google Search, Gmail, Google Drive, and YouTube. Verizon, CenturyLink, LinkedIn Corp are some of the other major customers of GCP. Even Apple uses Google Cloud Platform for data storage for its iCloud services, and most recently, GitLab and Twitter moved to Google Cloud as well. The unique thing about GCP is that it protects your data, applications, infrastructure, and customers from fraudulent activity, spam, and abuse with the same infrastructure and security services that Google uses internally. And that brings us to the end of this video regarding Google Cloud Platform. If you like the video, make sure to share it, subscribe to my channel, and hit that like button as well.